this skillful positions. God bless you. Hallelujah. Amen. Ooh. Have you given God some praise this morning?
I could have done that.
Praise Him. Make sure He hears your voice. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My voice shall be here. Hallelujah. Okay, we're going to receive Sister Pearl with this morning's announcements.
That you put the right person in charge, Pastor Williams, because Pastor Williams, he led morning prayer. He led Wednesday night school of the Bible. He taught Sunday school, and then he came back and he brought the Sunday's message, didn't he?
Amen. Amen. Yeah.
So he has done more than a great job. Let's see, Pastor Williams. Tuesday was a good meeting, and it was led by Sister Irene. And those of you that know Sister Irene, you know that she made it relaxing and very informative. Thank you, Sister Irene. Amen. I just want to let everyone know that I'm over fundraising for the Founders Committee. So if any of you have any ideas for fundraising for the Founders Committee, just come to me and I will see if I can implement those ideas, and then we can get started with that. And also the women, when you sell your tickets, you bring the money to me because I am the coordinator and I'm also the secretary of the Founders Committee. I will record the information, then I'll turn that money over to Sister Judy, who is the treasurer of the Founders Committee. Then she hands it to Tia. So again, ladies, when you get your ticket sales, please let me know. All right, the women's movement, I'm sure the women's movement was very enjoyable for the women that went. I did not go, me and Sister Wayne, because we went to visit Sister Cynthia. You remember Sister Cynthia? We all remember her. And she gave everyone a hello, so. Hello, everyone, from Sister Cynthia. Sister Cynthia. Oh, and I see Brother Elam back there. Praise God for Brother Elam. Amen. And we have a published author in our midst. Could Treasure Mason come forward? Published by Tate Publishing Company in Oklahoma City. And I would like for you to tell the name of your book.
It's called A Twisted Game Between Love and Lies.
And when did you write that book?
I wrote it during the summer.
This summer? Okay. It takes a lot of people some time to write a book, but she is a published author. Let's give her a hand. And for our visitors, I have Andrea Walton. Could you please stand? Amen, Andrea. Oh, from Fort Worth, Texas. We hope that you come by and visit Northside again, because here you'll always be celebrated. Amen. And Brother Curtis has some words.
Thank you, Sister Pearl. Give honor to God first in my life, Pastor Hill and Mother Hill, who's back with us. Thank God. My deal is today is to science for the last time. I'm not coming back up here again. I took the signs down on the other side because I just couldn't see them. And next Sunday, when we come here in this parking lot, from 46 and Harvard, we're going to be able to see that sign all the way down from here.
Praise God.
But it's a but to it. We got the west side, all of that paid for. Now we got to get the west side paid for. We got $130. We need $170 left. So the one who haven't paid, you know who. Sister Judy says she's not going to let you out the back today if you ain't paid. She going to be standing in the back at the door. She said that who ain't paid, she know because she got the name and she had her number. So if you want to get out, you better pay Sister Judy because she says she ain't going to let you out. So I'm asking everyone, you know who paid. You can still give another dollar to. It doesn't matter. But my goal is next week, them signs going to be up because I'm going to put them up. And I'm going to make sure that the sign is looking good. So when the people pass from the east to the west, they're going to be able to read it. And if anyone want to come and visit, they know what's the name of the church. They don't have to get all the way up to the sign and read it. So we want everyone who haven't paid, pay your $5, your $1, $2, whatever you haven't paid. And the one who have paid, if you have a little extra change you want to spur towards the sign, just go ahead and pay. So go ahead and get the sign up. Yeah, we have to shout because that last Sunday, the first Sunday when we paid, we would shout, dance, music on. That's the only way we got the money. We got to do that again. We need to go back and start shouting again. God bless you. All right, let's say praise the Lord, everyone. Okay, back to business at hand. Praise the Lord. We see the hills here, and they haven't went to Hawaii yet. What's up with that? I'm sure they still want to go, and we're still going to sing there. Amen. All in favor, say hallelujah. All right, praise God. You know where you are on your contributions. We should be almost to the end of that endeavor. If you haven't taken the balance of your pledge, get to working toward that. Get that in, praise God. Don't be left out. We heard some great testimonies. Sunday or so ago about giving, praise God, and if I only had $5, I would give that. If I only had 20, 30, that's what I would give, that's what I would plant. God knows what you're capable of. He says every man according to as he is has the ability to do it, praise God. A lot of us, most of us have the ability to give $100, amen? Amen, church? Amen. If you had a toothache and the dentist said, I need $100, would you give the $100? It's urgent. We got to get this $100 some kind of way. Praise God. So we want to put urgency on this endeavor as well. The Bible says, see that you abound in this grace also. And I know we are at least halfway. We wanted to get $4,000 in. So let's go ahead and make it three before this Sunday is over. How many say amen to that? How many say amen to that? Amen to that. You might say, well, my car needs an oil change. My car needs some fragrance smelling in it or something. Your pastor needs a trip of rest. I will be saying, what will we say? Amen. Let's get it done. Let's get it done. Let's get it done, friends. Let's talk about it. You never know how that seed is going to grow. It's like a baby in the womb. I don't know how they come out with blue eyes and blonde hair and a big nose, little nose, skinny ears. I don't know how that. The neck bone's connected to the shoulder bone, connected to the elbow. I don't know how that takes place. I just know what it's happening. Hallelujah. How many have contributed already, friends? You know, something's happening for you. Something's happening, praise God. As long as the herbs stand, it's going to be what kind of time? Seed time, harvest time, praise God. You got to get in on that. You got to get in on that. All right, don't forget the tithing. Don't want to suffer from tithing. Don't want the tithe to suffer. Don't want the church to suffer. You come in here, no lights. Hallelujah. Francis Padlock, all kinds of things. We don't want that, praise God. We're still going to pay our tithes. We're going to bring our offerings as well. And we know God loves the cheerful one. So let's all stand. That's our prayer over all of our giving. We're more than conquerors through Him that loved us. We're more than conquerors. We're more than able to take the land. Father, we thank you today for your kindness, your love toward us. You blessed us in all areas of our life. We have complete deliverance from all things that's contrary to your word. You delivered us from the power of darkness, brought us into the kingdom of light. And in that kingdom is blessing, prosperity, every good and every perfect gift coming down from you. We give you all the praise and glory in Jesus' name. Let the church say, amen. Amen. From the rear seats on each side of the room through the center aisle, will you bring your tithes and offerings? Founder of Northside Christian Center, James Hill. God bless you.